Hi, I'm Greg Meyer. I'm the Senior Product Manager here at Hunter Engineering, and Wheel Balancers is my product. Today we're going to talk about Road Force WalkAway, and specifically how do you use it, operations. How do you actually utilize this new feature? Let's talk with a little history first. If you're familiar with Road Force Balancers have become the standard in the industry. All OEs either strongly recommend or require you to have one. Why? Because we can fix vibrations. That part hasn't changed. That's been around. We have operations videos that talk about how to balance, how to measure road force, how to fix it, how to measure tire pull. We're going to link you to those videos. And if you're new to road force, I really highly recommend that you go check those out. Today, what we'd like to focus on are the major improvements of Road Force WalkAway. What is it? Well, if you remember with Road Force balancers in the past, if you've seen them, there was always an inflation system that was right here. There was a holster, a hose that would sit right there. You could pull the hose out and top off the air to make sure that we're at the set point pressure or the placard pressure. That was very important. Super handy to have that here. But now what have we done? We've actually just moved it over here. And you might think, well, big deal. What does that do for me? Well, it's now going to become a walkaway inflation system. Looks a lot like a data set arm, but it's going to function completely different. You notice we have an air hose. We now have a chuck that has this nice button on it. And when I push that button, it releases the chuck. Makes it nice and easy to put it on and off the wheel. But that's not what's important about this. What's important is that now the computer can automatically release this chuck. So what we can do is take a tire that's not fully inflated. It might only have 2, 5 PSI in it. Connect the chuck, pull the hood down, set my set point pressure to whatever the vehicle needs, and walk away. When I'm doing something else, the computer will inflate this to the set point pressure, release the chuck automatically. When we detect that it's home, we're going to then spin up the balancer, measure imbalance and road force, straight track, whatever you've told it to do. And when you come back, those numbers will be on the screen, you apply your weights, and off you go. That may not sound like a big deal, but in our studies, we've saved 10 to 15 minutes in a set of 4 tires. It's a 4 tire changeover, if you will. So these are really significant savings. So if you want to get faster and more productive, I suggest you take a look at this. So let's take a look at how we actually do that. Okay, so now we're going to roll the wheel up onto the wheel lift. Lift it into position. Slide it onto the collet. Clamp it up and just drop my wheel lift away so that I can bring the valve stem to the 9 o'clock position. Okay, that's even with the balancer shaft. We don't want the valve stem up here and we don't want it down here because it's more likely to bind the hose. If we put the valve stem here, that'll give the chuck the best chance of releasing and getting back into the arm. We have a backup plan and we'll talk about that in just a second. But what I do now that I'm at the 9 o'clock position, I release the chuck using the button, place it on the valve stem. Okay, you can hear it starts inflating right away, and I can hit my set point to whatever I need. And then I'm gonna walk away and go do something else. And it's calculating that time. When it hits the pressure that I've set it to, that chuck will release automatically. When it detects that it's home safely, and only when it detects that it's home safely, it will spin up and measure road force and imbalance, or whatever I've set it to do, and raise the hood, and we're finished. So let's talk a little bit about how the walkaway timer works. When we look at tires, obviously they vary in size a lot, little tires to big balloon mudder type tires. So inflation time varies a lot. So what we need to do is actually put some air in, see how quickly the pressure is going up or down to make an estimate. So you'll notice initially you don't see a walkaway time, but then in a few seconds it comes up on the screen. So let's show you how that works. So again, we connect the chuck as we do, and I'm gonna pull the hood down and you'll see it's thinking, seeing how fast, in this case, I'm going down in pressure. Once it has a few seconds, it can give you an estimate of the time, and then you can know how much time you have to go do something else. So some of you are probably thinking about seating the beads. Okay, and that's definitely a concern that we have an answer for with this machine. So to maximize walkaway time, we want to bring the tire over here essentially with no pressure in it. Now, that we don't always know if the tire is going to seal or hold air. So it's a good idea at the tire changer just to give it a few PSI, just to make sure it's holding air. but then we want to bring it to the balancer right away. Now, in that case, if we just put a few PSI in, very likely the beads have not snapped home or seated into place. So how do we know that they're going to seat before we get to set point pressure? Well, we thought about that, and in our beta testing, we discovered that that was a concern. And so here's what we've done. When you pull the chuck out, you will see a menu comes up over here, and there's this button right here that says enable bead seating. If we press that button, it's going to overinflate the tire by 50% and then sit there for 30 seconds and give those beads some time to snap into place, drop back down to set point pressure, then release the chuck. As before, when we see the chuck is safely home, then we'll spin up and measure road force and imbalance. So what that'll do is that will almost certainly guarantee that the beads get seated. Now, it's possible that even though we went 50% over pressure, that the beads still don't seat. Well, to be sure that we know that, we're gonna bring the load roller in. Even if you have turned off road force, we're gonna bring it in to check to ensure that the beads seated. If the beads didn't seat, we will get very high road force numbers. And those numbers are very easy to detect, and we will have a message on the screen when you come back that says, it doesn't look like these beads seated, please take a look. So you don't have to worry about whether the beads seated or not. Okay, let's say you've identified that this is a very challenging assembly, and you know this is off of a Corvette or something, a sports car, and I'm gonna have to go over 60 PSI. The balancer can only go to 60 PSI inflation pressure. That's regulation. We can go no higher unless it's in a safety cage or unless it's on the vehicle, okay? So if you have to go, you think, well, I know this assembly's tough, I'm gonna have to go to 70 or 80 PSI to get this one to seat. That's okay, roll it into the cage, get it to that pressure, but now don't deflate the tire and stand there and watch it, because we can use road force walk away to save time going down in pressure, just like we save time going up. So let's say it was 72 PSI. We bring it over at 72 PSI, we connect the chuck, set our set point to whatever we need, 35 PSI, whatever that may be, and then we pull the hood down and we go do something else. It's gonna take it some time to drop from 72 to 35. That will also be walk away time, and it will spin up and measure imbalance and road force just as it did before. So don't worry about having to overinflate. There's time savings potential there as well. Let's say you want to give your customer the absolute best product you can give them. That means giving them the lowest road force numbers they can have and therefore the smoothest ride on their vehicle. Well, if that's the case, you may already know about bead massage. Bead massage is a procedure that's done on the tire changer where we roll the beads of the tire using the roller of the tire changer, and that lowers road force numbers by 7 pounds on average. That's a significant reduction, therefore a noticeable improvement for your customers. You might think, well, if I have to inflate on the changer, how am I still gonna save time on road force walkaway? Well, the answer is just inflate till the beads seat. Maybe that's 20 pounds, maybe that's 25 pounds of pressure. Then we roll the beads and bring it over and finish inflation on road force walkaway. We still save time, we still massage the beads, and we gave the customer the best possible product in the least amount of time. Let's say we have an assembly and we either need to inflate or deflate it, but we're not balancing it. We can do that as well with this machine. So what we do is we just roll it onto the wheel lift, hang it on the shaft, just put it somewhere where it's not gonna go anywhere, so it's safely secured. Connect our chuck, set our set point to whatever we need to go to. In this case, I'll go to 30 PSI. Because the hood is up, it's not gonna automatically release the chuck. And that's because we don't want you to get hit by this chuck as it releases. So basically the hood up says, hey, I'm gonna do this manually. When it hits the pressure, it's gonna beep at me and let me know that it's finished. Now I can just disconnect the chuck, take the wheel off the shaft, and do whatever I need to do. Let's say we don't need to inflate this tire. We've already put pressure in it on the tire changer, and all we need to do is check balance, whatever the case may be. I don't have to use the inflation system on this. Just as in the previous generations of road force balancers, we didn't have to use the inflation system here. I don't have to use this. I can just clamp it up, pull the hood down, measure imbalance and road force, or whatever I need to do. There are many different wheel designs out there. Therefore, the valve stems end up in all sorts of interesting positions. Sometimes the valve stem is rubber, can be metal, can be at unusual angles. Maybe we didn't position it just right. All of these things can cause the chuck not to release properly. So there's a procedure that will handle that, and let me show you how that works. So I'm gonna connect this chuck and pull the hood down. And what I'm gonna do is intentionally not let the chuck get home. If you remember it, I mentioned that the chuck has to safely get home. We have to detect that it's home before we'll spin the balancer. And it'll do this so that you can see what will happen. It's gonna rock the wheel once it hits pressure. I'm gonna hold it. And now I'm not gonna let it go home. And the sensor says, uh-oh, something's wrong. Notice it's cycling the chuck to try to shake it free, and it's servoing the wheel back and forth, again, to help it shake free. When it detects that the chuck is safely home, then it's gonna spin up, measure and balance, and complete the job. When you come back, it will have completed the job as normal. Now, if the chuck never got home, you would see an error message on the screen that tells you to please release the chuck. You would still have saved the inflation time, but you would just watch it finish the balance spin and then continue on balancing the tire. So now we've covered operations for the Road Force Walkaway Balancer. If you have additional questions, please check out the videos that we've linked to or go to our Hunter Learning channel to learn more. If you have even still further questions, don't hesitate to contact your local Hunter service representative. They can provide additional training or fill in some of those gaps or answer those specific questions that you might have. Thank you very much for watching.